Very interesting table, very significant one. As you can see in a small area, you have base meetings in the Torah of Gog, black Gog, green Umagog. Don't come together, but this is how they appear. Base meeting in the old Torah, and interesting, it comes in one book, Genesis, and even in one chapter. And from verse 1 to 9, very interesting, significant. So what is the location and what this really table teaches us? Unbelievable. So what I was looking for, not only Gog Umagog, but what is behind, what the Torah tells us about there. And definitely important teaching for our time, maybe important messages. So what did I do? The first thing, according to our tradition, the war of Gog Umagog will take place on the last day of Sukkot, which is called Hoshana Rabbah. There is an interesting explanation why, because in Sukkot we've been bringing 70 bullocks for the whole world, for nations. So whatever it is, Gog Umagog will be in the month of Tishrei. You can see Tishrei is a month of Rosh Hashanah, of Sukkot, Yom Kippur, right? Then it comes parallel to Gog. Interesting. You must know all the time I tell you that parallel is not coincidence. It comes parallel, not like other tables, you know. But Gog and parallel come Tishrei. So Gog will be on Tishrei and Sukkot. Then, which year? So I put the year 5782 because the 7181 is already finished in a month's time. So, and in fact, one should know, it's written, if unfortunately we don't do tshuva before, so this will be the sabbatical year because the coming year, 5782, is sabbatical year, which is called Shemitah. Shvi'i, the seventh one. It is very interesting that in the Torah, the word Ashvi written without Yud, that the Gematria will come exactly like this year. Comes to the Gematria of 5782. 782, amazingly. So, clearly shows a very serious situation. Because our rabbis tell us in the Talmud that the sabbatical year will be year with wars, milchamot, and towards the end we'll say Shvi'it will be Messiah. Interesting. If you will marry. Amazing, when I looked for this year, 5782, it came also parallel. You can see a top shin pei bet. And itself also very significant. Yeah? I should know that parallel, not only small ski, but parallel. So you have clearly go in the month of Tishrei, in the year 5782. And in fact, you go down, we see here Sukkot also parallel. This is exactly the festival when Gog Umagog will take place. So seeing parallel Gog, Tishrei, this year, and Sukkot is far away from being significant. Now, definitely we refer to the prophet Ezekiel, chapter 32, verse 1-2, but in fact, later on, I mean after 3, 4, 5, you have definitely more about Gog Umagog, but I took the first two, which says, so mortal, turn your face towards Gog, of the land of Magog, the chief prince of Meshech, and Tubal prophesy against him and say, thus says the Lord God, look, I am coming to deal with you, O Gog, chief prince of Meshech, and Tubal. Okay, carry on, but it is interesting what commentator says, because those names are not known today, but for example, the Talmud Yerushalmi says that Meshech is like for Moscow, yeah? Russia, yeah. Then, balsams, Tiras, we have others, we have Persia, we have Germany, like Gomer, Germany, so all those are indicated here. Now it is known according to our tradition, Prophet Chaim says that will be three, the war of Gog and Magog will be divided to three parts. The first one, says the Chafetz Chaim, was the First World War. Then he said it will be another one, the second one, that will be. And this is the Second World War. Then he said it will be a third one, that comparing to the first and the two, the first and the two will be like a game, like a joke. And say, I think he says, but he said it will take minutes. No, now it's there, so we can understand very well. And with the news also, as the news say, you heard the news today that in about 6 weeks, Iran will have an atom bomb. No, you see, exactly will be around this time. No, we have to pray that it will not happen, but God wants to show you that you have to remember that if you don't keep the Torah, you are in again danger. 150,000 missiles in North towards Israel in the north. Thousands, many thousands of south rockets also. Iran, Hezbollah, all those. Not simple at all the situation. So let us see now the table and what is really in this table. So the first thing, as I told you, I look for the best meeting of Gog and Magog. Could not come in one word. Gog and Magog. Yeah, Gog and Magog. Gog and Magog, best meeting. By the way, Gog and Magog is in a Mercury value of 70, indicating to the 70 nations of the world, I mean, the basis of the whole world, the nations are 70. In fact, the Vilna Gaon says it's divided into 35 and 35, Islam, Ishmael, and Adam, Christianity. So, what is written here? Exactly what the prophet says. Yechezkel, Bnei Yefet, Gomer u'Magog. The children of Yefet are Gomer u'Magog. Gomer, as I said, according to rabbis, some say Germany. Yeah. Then you have afterwards Madai. Madai is like Persia. And then you have Meshech. Meshech, the Talmud Yerushalmi said Meshech is like Moscow, Russia. No, all those were connected in the World War, right? Then you have here Putin, Kush, also different opinions. Some say it is Iran and Turkey. Then you have Edom. Edom is a general name for Europe. Then you have the Nimrod, the story of the Torah. You know, Nimrod was a man who rebels against God, married, rebellious. And according to Kabbalah, yeah, Gog is a reincarnation of Nimrod, yeah, also rebelling against God. Nimrod, interesting, Nimrod comes here also. Then, as I said, the continuation of this table, the same place, you can see Aleph and Yud, the same chapter, a little bit more chapter. You have Sukkot, when we'll have this, and Palestinians will join this war against Israel, Egyptian also, sure, Syria. All this what we see today. So as I said, all together is unbelievable that every 12 letters, there is a great significance to number 12, 12 zodiac, 12 tribes, comes here and telling us exactly what our Rebbe said many thousands years ago, that on the festival Sukkot and Tishrei, yeah, Gog and Magog will be. And now comes exactly this year. So, let us hope that by prayer, especially there now we have the day of hope, Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, we'll repent, we'll keep all the Torah. And Gentiles definitely have to keep the seven laws of Noah. Most severe one are abortion, homosexualism, sexuality, which was the reason for the flood, or by Stelas, the Torah said, because the generation was corrupted, this is why the flood came. And our Rebbe said, that's why the Torah have to specify 40 days. What is different? So say, because 40 days is a time that the fetus, the embryo, gets its shape, yeah? Medically, it is known. And God was so angry, full of wrath, he said, I will destroy this world because they caused me to create fetus and embryo 40 days and destroy them. So I will destroy the world. There will be floods all over the world. Our rabbis tell us that floods all over the world will not be now, but it will be countries like Germany, China, Japan. Yeah, we will have still floods to remind us that there is a God. But all over the world, our rabbis say, will not be a flood of water, but it will be a flood of corona, of leprosy. It's written, there is a Midrash Homiletic in Song of Songs, which says that before the coming of the Messiah, Dever Gadol Bal Olam, Dever Gadol is like pestilence, that pestilence will come to the world, but always the term pestilence is not only pestilence, it is any kind, corona, typhus, and cholera, all kinds of plagues which the world went through. It's amazing. This was the why, was it the purpose? Because God wants people to believe there is a God. And you can see in the state, two-thirds say that they believe the corona is from heaven, Delta from heaven. No, very nice, but they have to believe more that God gave them seven laws of Noah, and the most severe ones are homosexuality and abortion. They have to remember this, and this is why the flood came. This is why so many troubles. No, they should know this. It's nice that they believe, two-thirds believe that it's from God. Allah in Israel will be like this, but they have to they think further if there is a God. They feel there is sin and punishment. The Torah says, if you keep the laws, fine. If not, the flood comes. It's written, the people were corrupted, tishachet. And it's written which kind of shritut immorality. Clearly, it's in homosexualism. Clearly, the Midrash brings this. And this is why a flood came. This is why disaster came to the world. No. Unfortunately, you know, this is the Democrats believe. Yeah, they should allow permission. They should permit homosexualism, abortion, yeah. And this was being anger, wrath to the world. And this, we have the Delta comes, the corona, and all these terrible troubles and floods, heat, and which never was such a thing. We have to believe that everything from God. I told you once to look at the prophecy in Sophania 3, chapter 3, and to read from 7, 8, 9, oh, I think to start even that. The verses, so we see exactly the news, everything, what is going on in the world, and God said, what you see is a disaster, floods, and destruction. Tikhi Musar, I want you to learn from it. You will learn, and then the Torah carries on, and God says, no, you carry on corrupting, carry on doing wrong things. So then God says, this is frightening. I told you then, there is a verse in the old Bible, the verse Sephania, chapter 3, verse 8, which describe Gog and Magog, the war of Gog and Magog. There are 26 verses there, and all the alphabets are there, 27 of the alphabets, the final is to tell us, yeah, that if Jews will not learn from all what is going on in the world, and will carry on, not only Jews, all words, then oh, you will have a Gog and Magog. And Gog and Magog, ha ha, not simple at all. So interesting and important and significant table, and hoping that people already will realize that the Bible code, Torah code, is the blueprint of creation. As I said, you can see it. All the great Kabbalists said, Moshe Kadevero, Abu Lafia, Rabbeinu Bachya, 800 years ago, in his book, you can read it in Bereshit, the first Sedra, about the moon and the star, he brings them a Bible code of 42 letters, like the name of God, which clearly indicates to the exact time when the moon starts functioning. And this is for us, for Jews, is the basis of what every new month, yeah, they declare, they announce exactly the second when the moon will start. And now we know it, we know it. From this tradition, from the Bible code 42, 42 Anna Bechor, the name of God. Unbelievable. Yes, this is it. NASA knew it only when they managed to get satellites to go around the moon and to find out how long takes the time of the moon. But we know in the Talmud is written, Rosh Hashanah, exactly the time of the moon is 29 days, 12 hours, and 793 portion. What is portion? At that time, the hour at 1080 parts was the best number. Yeah, this is, right? No doubt. This is so. So now with the satellites, you can see the names. By the way, Professor Aralik, with whom I work, who became really very connected with the Torah course, he was inspector of the satellites in Pasadena. So, interesting and significant table, no doubt. Clearly show the Torah was a blueprint for creation. Baruch Hashem, people, serious people, who think properly, who concentrate properly, became really religious Orthodox because of this. This program, Professor Dr. Rottenberg, is a scientist from Russia. Like Professor Hibbs. Professor Hibbs told me about this phenomenon of the cause. He looked into it and he said, oh, definitely Torah from heaven. But then he became Orthodox Jew. He wrote a book about the cause and all his truths in English. You can get it. And he made this program, you know, that you see it after the letter. And I use it and others use it. And clearly seeing the Torah, all what is going on in the world. So, and same thing, Professor Michelson, also a Russian scientist. Yeah, he was essayist when he came to Israel. Then he was working with Doron Wissing, and he saw how significant are the laws. So he became very Orthodox, and he's a great scholar now, writes books. So this is the truth, that the Torah is a blueprint of creation. It should strengthen our faith and keep the Torah. Jews 613 commandments, and Shabbos, and Gentiles, the seven commandments, if they want the world, the world will go on properly. No troubles like we have today. And they get rid of the corona and the Delta. No. So, interesting and significant table about Gog and Magog.